Please put your hands together. Put your hands together. See the music, man. When you see young achievers, he's dancing up, he's not walking up. Professor Pichawa, on the one that
he can make me go from over
you don't want me to start singing here. You see, you get 500 people the way you represent. And 500 registered people, then you forget the other one never was. You see, no many registered members. I was very worried if the Department of Home Affairs did ever hear. Thank you. And then, you know, the color today, they say it's red. I see Madame is wearing red. They say they find that PhD too. You two just decide for where you are red and your own fever gown. Now, a very good thing we will see. And I don't know where your co-MC is, you run. You mash, mash money, go shoot. We need to check your other shoe. You can start with the mash and the suit. Let's check where some of that. And then they say the money don't come, and then the man will only ask for offerings. And again, that country talk, you are welcome. That country talk where they say what you talk, and be very careful though. Don't mind that talk where they talk. And if you come up on Jembe, you feel talk that kind of talk. All protocols observed. I'm very honored, Your Royal Highness, and the Queen for inviting me this evening to come and share what is a wonderful moment in the lives of your family, but most importantly, the community that you serve. Having listened to so many people, I mean, I don't know why you didn't use to say be professor, because you just talk your work. But education is the most powerful tool that you can use to change the world, in the words of Nelson Mandela. And it is no fluke, it is true. And I repeat, education is the most powerful tool that we can use to change the world. Here we are today seated with a community leader and the wife showing us the example of what it is that we need to do to move the world forward, but to start by also moving our community forward through education. And I was just sitting there praying that nobody should say it. But when I looked at what he is graduating in, Masters in Innovation. Masters in Innovation. The first thing I turned around and I told my wife was, wow, okay. Masters in Innovation. And then I just thought about what innovation means. I don't want to go into defining innovation. But we are in the era of the fourth industrial revolution, where we need leaders in society today that think out of the box. We need as community to innovate. And here is the king that has gone forward to study on innovation. I have no doubt that you will use this degree to innovate your community and the people that you serve. I was very touched, but I want to encourage you that that black rob must turn to red.
Oh yes.
Because if you can have a master's degree in innovation, you can have a PhD in innovation.
Oh, yes.
And you can then join Madame, whom, you know, when I see women graduate with PhDs, I've graduated one lady with a PhD, and there's two more about to.